Corpus Christi Islanders taking on the McNeese Cowboys. And a very pleasant good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tom Franklin. Alongside is Jeff Power. And Jeff, we've got a battle of two teams trying to make the postseason. Only 8 of the 13 in the Southland get to go to Katy for the postseason tournament. Both of these teams have designs on getting there. Texas A&M Corpus Christi trending in the right direction, winners of 5 of their last 7. However, McNeese going the opposite way. They've dropped 8 of 10.
Yeah, in fact, Willis Wilson, the head coach of the Islanders, he knows they've won 4 in a row. They've been playing great. Good to have Rashawn Thomas back. And Dave Simmons, on the other hand, he's got to right the ship. There's still a chance to get into that postseason tournament.
Conference standings are very well bunched up, and even though McNeese is sitting at 4-8, as you mentioned, there's a long way to go, and they can certainly make their way to Katy. Two players to keep an eye on in today's ball game. For the Islanders, it is Rashawn Thomas, their outstanding player of the year candidate at the center spot.
Yeah, Rashawn Thomas, so good to have him back on the floor. He's been playing lights out lately, averaging about 25 points per game, 20 right now overall for the season, and 8.7 rebounds per contest. He's been their key player.
For the McNeese Cowboys, they're going to rely on the guy to get them in motion properly, and that'll be point guard Jemiah Burr. He likes to score, but he needs to get the other guys involved.
Yeah, Jemiah Burr, he averaged about 15 points a game last year, was the leading scorer. This year, 12 points per contest, still the leading scorer, was not in the starting lineup last week. In fact, that was done by Jaron Greenwood, who's actually perhaps out for this game with a possible injury to his hand.
Even more important is that Burr steps up at the point guard spot for the Cowboys today. Coming up, we'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip-off for today's ball game from Burton Coliseum here in Lake Charles right after this timeout. And we're back here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana. Texas A&M Corpus Christi against McNeese this afternoon in Southland Conference basketball action. Right now, let's take a look at today's starting lineups. First of all, for the visitors from Texas A&M Corpus Christi, Joe Kilgore, along with Ehab Amin, one of the leaders in the country in steals, averaging nearly 4 steals a game. Kareem South is a young redshirt freshman who's starting to find his game for the Islanders. Jake Coer is a sixth-year player because of injuries. And the leader of the group, Rashawn Thomas, the 6'8 senior out of Oklahoma City, averaging 20 points and 10 rebounds a game. Now for McNeese, Jemiah Burr, the guy we talked about at the start. He's going to have to keep this offense in motion. James Harvey, they need him to hit shots early because that builds his confidence and helps their offense. Caleb Ledoux is a young freshman who's made an impact. Lance Porche is the glue man for Dave Simmons' bunch. And Steven Ugochukwu rounds things out, and they need to keep him out on the floor. At 6'7", 220 out of Louisville, they need his presence to battle with Rashawn Thomas. Only played 14 minutes in that tough loss to New Orleans on Thursday night, Jeff.
Yeah, you know, Texas A&M Corpus Christi has won the last 5 meetings in this rivalry versus McNeese State. McNeese averaging 69.3 per game as far as points scored, giving up 78 per game, which has been one of their Achilles heels so far this year. A&M Corpus Christi has done a little bit better, 75.2 points per game as far as scoring and giving up 74.2.
So we look for things to happen. Willis Wilson always concerned when you come here to Lake Charles. This McNeese team, regardless of the record, dangerous at home and unpredictable on defense. And easily winning the opening tip was Ugochukwu. It's almost like Thomas didn't even bother. That was interesting. Here's Ledoux from the right wing. getting the Cowboys off to a fast start with a three ball.
They got off to a good start against the Pioneers of New Orleans the other night, but couldn't hold on down the stretch due to foul trouble.
Of course, Dave Simmons' bunch is going to have to contain Rashawn Thomas. You saw him there at the top of the arc. You see him with the headband, easy to find. They feed him inside for the fadeaway that's short. Good defense by Ugochukwu, but Amin runs down the rebound and a second chance. Floater by South won't get the friendly roll, and Porche will clear for the Cowboys. Good possession for the Islanders, just couldn't get it to fall on two opportunities.
You know, the Southland Conference is so bunched up this year, Tom.
Just
from
amazing.
Top to bottom, all the way.
The statistics, just incredible.
I mean, this is a pivotal game, really, for both teams.
The Islanders would like to be in the top four. Think they can be there. Meanwhile, the Cowboys with one on the clock. Ugochukwu fired a wild one, but got rim. Thomas takes the rebound down, and the Islanders come back the other way. Amin with a turnaround from the left side of the lane is good. Ehab Amin, their second leading scorer at 17-6 per ball game.
You know, McNeese with a 4-8 record. I mean, in the win column, only two back of A&M Corpus Christi, but there's about six teams in between them.
You know, it's been a funny season for the Cowboys. As the three from Harvey rims in and out, another rebound for Thomas. They won their first two games in conference. Then have dropped 8 of 10 since then as Kilbore with the floater. Gives A&M Corpus Christi their first lead at 4-3. But then they went on this spiral where they've dropped 8 of their last 10. Dave Simmons, when you talked to him, said we could have won easily 4 of those ball games. We just haven't learned how to finish.
Steven Ugochukwu, we've got to keep him out of foul trouble if they can.
Traveled right there at the top of the arc. So the turnover will give the ball back. You see Willis Wilson, the sixth-year head coach at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, picked up his 300th career victory with a 73-68 win over UTSA back on December the 18th.
Rashawn Thomas coming off a game where he had 32 points against HBU.
Amin out high, being guarded by Poche. Here's Thomas trying to work on Ugochukwu in the lane for 2-and-1, and Ugochukwu is going to get the whistle.
That's what they've got to avoid. They don't want him in foul trouble. He got in foul trouble the other night, only played 2 minutes in the second half.
Watch a strong move from Thomas here. Thomas with his first bucket. Free throw completes the three-point play.
Thomas had 27 against UCA, 22 against Lamar, 28 against ACU. Been on a roll lately.
And a three ball back the other way for Caleb Ledoux. So he's been the offense guy for the Cowboys. They trail by one here, almost 3 minutes gone by. Amin can't get through. He goes back out to Thomas. He'll take the 17-footer that's good. Shows you he can do it inside and out.
A 15-footer right there. He's got a great form. Moves the ball well on the ground, the dribble.
I've been calling Southland Conference games for 3 years now. To see him as a sophomore compared to where he is as a senior, it is unbelievable the way he's changed. And Jemiah Burr with a three. So that is three threes for McNeese to tie the game at 9 apiece.
Maya Burr out of Ruston High School in Ruston, Louisiana.
Looking for Thomas down low. He got free from Ugochukwu and softly lays it home. 7 early points for Rashawn Thomas. Ugochukwu had it swiped away by Amin, but Ledoux recovers for the Cowboys, and they'll keep possession with 17 to shoot.
Amin with such quick hands, you got to know where he's at on the floor at all times. Gets a lot of steals.
That's why he's one of the leaders in the country. Ball knocked out of bounds by Jake Kohler. We'll stop the clock here with 15:56 to go here in the opening half. We're at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, and off to a quick start for both teams. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a 2-point advantage over McNeese, thanks to 7 early points from Rashawn Thomas. The officials want to know if you have an angle on the first three-pointer of the ball game in the first 14 seconds to see if it was a three or a two. They would like to see it, though. Okay. Back here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Texas A&M Corpus Christi versus McNeese in Southland Conference basketball. And today's game is brought to you by Universal Coin and Bullion, the official coin and bullion dealer of the Southland Conference. Just over 4 minutes going by here. Didn't have a really good look. The officials want to know if that first basket by Caleb Ledoux was a three or a two. And we had bodies in the way, so we didn't have a good shot of it.
Yeah, clearly
it's
behind the
clearly
line.
Clearly a three. Clearly a three as we got a second look at it. And so the score will stay at 11-9 in favor of the Islanders.
Good to be helpful out here.
Well, you know.
Hand the monitor over.
Hey, they're in charge of this game. We have to follow what they said.
Exactly.
Remember, broadcasters have been ejected from ball games before. Here's a three
trying to jinx
off the mark
time.
By Burr. I'm just saying you keep your mind in order here.
Okay, all right.
Kareem South will put it back outside to Amin. The Islanders circulate against the man-to-man defense. Amin down on the block against Poche. Can't get the up and under, goes back outside. South for three. Kareem South. Top 20 prospect out of Canada when signed by the Islanders 2 years ago, redshirted last year. He's starting to find his game, averaging 8.4 now on the season. Checking in the game there is zero. That's Kyle Brown, giving Burr a hard time in the point guard spot.
Now South had 22 points recently in the game. He's been lighting it up from behind the arc.
Poked away from behind by Amin, who may have drawn a foul, trying to get the steal on Poche. And it will be the first foul against Ehab Amin. Let's take a look again. Yeah, had his hands clearly all over him in the back as he tried to enter. And Rashawn Thomas will check back in. Joe Kilgore will sit down. Perry Francois has come in for his first action. Number 10, 6'8 freshman out of North Miami, Florida. Here's Poche through a double team. Couldn't get it to go, but will shoot free throws.
Saw the opening, went strong to the rim. That's what you got to do. Now he heads to the charity stripe.
Francois is going to get the whistle. Watch it again. Saw Francois over the top. Thomas had him guarded pretty well face up, but when Francois came from the backside, that's where the contact initiated. Lance Poche, 6'6 senior out of St. Martinsville, Louisiana. Missing the first free throw. 58% on the year. Coming off a double-double with 11 points and 10 rebounds in the loss to New Orleans here Thursday night.
So Willis Wilson there went to Rice, 82 graduate. Dave Simmons, on the other hand, played at Louisiana Tech, 81 graduate. Simmons in his 11th year as the head coach of McNeese.
Amin pulls up just inside the arc, can't get it to go, and maybe Francois again over the back on the rebound. It is.
Tough break for Francois. That ball kind of hung on the rim and caught him in no man's land.
That'll bring Joe Kilgore back. Islanders trying to go a little big with two big men. They're going to go back small as Kilgore comes back in. And Burr will let the ball roll almost to midcourt before picking it up.
Never know when you'll need those seconds.
Here's Ledoux from the corner. Can't hit this time. And Thomas with another rebound. Thomas inside the arc from 15, left it short. South couldn't get the rebound. Poche does. And back come the Cowboys. Harvey had it swatted away by Thomas, but it winds up with McNeese. They go down low, Poche, up and under, and got it over Amin. First field goal for Lance Poche makes it a two-point game. Amin in the lane. We're going to get a blocking foul against McNeese. Poche can't believe it. Poche with his first second against McNeese. And Ehab Amin will go to the free throw line.
Amin has kind of been the catalyst for this team, not only defensively, but we saw in the game against SFA recently how he can really kind of take a game over, especially in that second half against the Jacks.
Misses the first free throw, however. That's kind of rare for Amin, who's 81% from the line. One for two for Ehab Amin. Makes it a 15-12 ball game with 13:45 left here in the opening half.
Now, these two teams have actually met in Houston a few times. 2-4 over there in favor of McNeese.
Oh, Poche almost fumbled it. Got it inside for Uguchukwu. Left it short. Got the tip. Couldn't get it to go. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch, they say, by McNeese. Very physical underneath the basket there. A couple of good looks here for Uguchukwu. Watch.
A lot of blue jerseys around him.
One, two, and then couldn't get three. A little 1-2-2 zone trap. No problem for the Islanders. Mentioned at the outset that Dave Simmons likes to be unpredictable with his defenses, changing them all the time. Thomas, the turnaround eight-footer, won't go. Rebound Harvey will secure for McNeese. 7 minutes gone by. Three-point game in favor of the Islanders on defense.
You know, Burton Coliseum used to be part of the rodeo circuit. You got a chance to see some roping going on outside, just outside the venue here before things got underway. Warmer than usual than in Louisiana here this time of year.
And Rashawn Thomas, nope. I'm going to call it against Joe Kilgore. Gets his first foul here.
Got the body right there. And
there's the reach in by Kilgore. So Steven Uguchukwu, 69% from the line. Gets on the score sheet. Had 4 points and three rebounds, but only played 14 minutes Thursday night against New Orleans because he fouled out of the ballgame. Ehab Amin will sit down as Colin Hale will check in, number 20. He's a 6'1". Freshman out of Aransas Pass down near Corpus Christi. Uguchukwu makes both free throws. He'll have a seat, and Lavarius Hill will come in. Hill is the usual backup for Uguchukwu, and he didn't do any better against New Orleans. He had one rebound in 6 minutes because he fouled out in 6 minutes. That's a foul a minute. It's crazy.
Yeah, that's rough.
1 point game, Islanders with the ball in the lead. Hale has to come back outside with it. Found Hale underneath, kicks it back out for South 3. Yes, good ball movement by the youngster Hale to find another youngster South for a three ball. Ledoux will try to answer, short, and Kilgore will get the rebound.
South's been a big reason why the Islanders have had a lot of success lately, winning four in a row.
Got a collision in the corner as Jake Coher takes the spill, and Poche pick up his second. That could be key for McNeese here. He's one of their solid players, but the pump fake got Poche up in the air. Coher a little bit late with the release to get the shooting violation. Instead, the ball will stay with A&M Corpus Christi. New 30 on the clock. They'll inbound from down near the corner.
Got to go up vertical if you're going to try to block a shot. You don't want to be off balance, leaning into someone.
Coher gets it out to South. Back iron this time. Rebound batted around. Thrown back in bounds. Thomas has got it. Tried to muscle it up around Hill and got fouled. And Liberius Hill will pick up his first foul. 11:55 to play. First half here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles. Texas A&M Corpus Christi riding a four-game winning streak off to an early four-point lead.
been thinking about diversifying with gold but don't know how? Hi, I'm Mike Fulgens, president of Universal Coin and Bullion. As an award-winning nationwide dealer, we help clients get the answers they need to discover the beauty, security, and strength of gold in their portfolio.
Call us today at 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. That's 866-822-4843.
10 years of intensity. 10 years of dunks. 10 years of three-pointers. 10 years of drives. 10 years of teamwork. 10 years of leadership. 10 years of hustle. 10 years of champions. A decade in Katy. The 2017 Southland Basketball Tournament, March 8th through the 12th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Just as mighty oak trees grow strong in contrary winds, McNeese State University continues to thrive despite the current economic climate. For 5 consecutive years, McNeese has been named one of the best regional universities in the South by U.S. News & World Report. Best Value Schools also ranked McNeese one of the best schools in the state for affordability and return on investment for its graduates. See for yourself why a degree from McNeese just makes sense. Call or visit us online to schedule a campus tour.
A&M-Corpus Christi over McNeese. 11:55 to play here in the first half, and Rashawn Thomas will have free throws. As play resumes, Thomas with 7 quick points for the Islanders, making his second trip to the line in tonight's ball game.
They've had a big advantage in the paint, mainly due to Thomas.
68% free throw shooter. He's knocked down a pair here to up the lead to 5. And make it 6. He has 9 of their 20. And you know, the biggest lead of the ball game at 6 points for the Islanders.
As a team, Texas A&M Corpus Christi only shoots 32% from behind the arc. So it's important to have Thomas in the game, get that inside presence going. Then that 3-point shot can open up for him a little bit better. That's why they've been winning lately.
Harvey will take a 3, won't go. Rebound tipped and controlled by Thomas. And for Rashawn Thomas, make that rebound number 4 in the ball game already. Kilgore with a hard drive, couldn't get the roll, but Thomas has the putback. And Rashawn Thomas in double figures now with 11. And make it 5 rebounds in the early going. The lead is 8 for the Islanders. 9 minutes gone by here. Been a while since McNeese had a bucket. Burr double teamed out top. Finds Ugochukwu at the elbow. Gets the return pass for 3. It's good. Jamiah Burr with his second 3-ball. He's got 6, as does Caleb Ledoux.
Cuts the lead to 22-17. They need that shot from Burr. He's their leader. He's the man that's led him in scoring the last 2 years, and he can hit that 3, that's for sure.
McNeese had gone almost 4 minutes without a field goal before that 3-ball. Hale will fire from on top, and he'll knock it home. Colin Hale with his first basket of the ball game. Had 6 points against Southeast Louisiana on Wednesday night in their 80-75 win. Almost a steal, is a steal by Rashawn Thomas. Took it right away from Jacob Ledoux. Yes, the Ledoux's are twins, Jacob and Caleb. High floater is no good by Kilgore. Rebound tipped into the arms of Thomas.
Good hustle by Hale there to get it to Thomas.
Drive to the basket by South, put back by Kilgore. And right now, the Islanders are the tougher team inside, Jeff.
Yeah, they've owned the glass. They've got a 10-point lead now. A lot of rebounds, a lot of good second chance opportunities. Got a 10-5 advantage in rebounds.
Jacob Ledoux hasn't seen as much time as his brother because he got hurt around Christmas time. Hill had the ball stripped away, and Thomas, quick outlet pass to Kilgore. Now to Hale, back to Kilgore. Got caught in no man's land. Ball goes out of bounds. And we'll go over to McNeese. They kind of messed up that 3-on-2 break that time.
Yeah, good defensive effort on the other side.
South and Kilgore have a seat. Amin comes back in, and David Bloom will make his first appearance, number 5.
Caleb Ledoux checks back in for McNeese. He's out of Port Barry, Louisiana.
So both Ledoux brothers are on the floor with Harvey and Burr and Ugochukwu.
He's the one hitting the threes early.
Here's Amin off the side of the backboard. Ugochukwu with the rebound. Caleb Ledoux trying to drive the baseline. The floater is good.
Well done. Thought about the three, dribbled up, got a much easier high percentage shot closer to the basket.
Got the 10-foot floater. Dave Simmons says Caleb is the true scorer of the two. Thomas fouled on his drive to the basket. Foul's going to be on Ugochukwu, and it'll be his second. Watch here. Ugochukwu just trying to cut him off and slap away. First appearance for Richard LeCoux, number 3, checking into the ball game for McNeese. New 30 on the clock, as that's just 5 team fouls against McNeese, 4 against A&M Corpus Christi. Bean will run the point now from out high, working against Burr. They find Thomas for the turnaround 15-footer that goes over the front edge of the iron. 13 now for Rashawn Thomas, showing you why he was a first-team All-Southland Conference pick in the preseason and a solid candidate for Player of the Year honors.
Playing like a senior.
Ugochukwu from the double team. Kicks it out to LeCoux. It's short. And Hale gets the rebound for the Islanders. Ahead for Coher. Coher to the basket. Left it short. Influenced nicely by the tough defense from LeCoux. The ball goes out of bounds and over to McNeese. So that's a couple of breaks in a row now. The Islanders have failed to convert.
Well, you got to like the hustle, though, nonetheless, for the Islanders. Just getting down the floor, trying to make something happen.
Bloom was down there trying to clean up the mess and couldn't get the loose ball. Under 8 to play here in the first half. Caleb Ledoux against Hale. They switch out high. Jacob Ledoux had it poked away. They fight for it and take it away by Coher. Ahead it goes for, oh, look at that play by Colin Hale. One hand on the upward rise of the bounce and just scooped it in one motion. How about that?
Again, good hustle by Hale, just getting down the floor.
He knows how to score. He scored over 2,900 points at Aransas Pass. Loose ball, Hale tried to save it, couldn't, stepped on the end line. They'll go over to McNeese when play resumes. We have an officials timeout on the floor, 7:18 to go here in the first half. And Texas A&M Corpus Christi has taken a close ball game and blown it open quickly here. They're up by a dozen. Behind 13 from Rashawn Thomas.
7:21 to play here in the opening half at Burton Coliseum.
And Texas A&M Corpus Christi has erupted to take a 12-point lead at 31-19. 13 points and 6 rebounds already for Rashawn Thomas. And second chance points and points off turnovers, 7-0, basically because A&M Corpus Christi hasn't turned the ball over yet in the ball game.
The Islanders have played pretty clean throughout this game. Both sides of the ball, good hustle too. So 52% from the field for A&M Corpus Christi to just 40% from McNeese.
Here's Harvey trying to get by Bloom, pulls up from 15. Tough shot for James Harvey. His first bucket of the ball game. 10-point game now as we go under 7 minutes to play.
Yeah, McNeese was kind of relying on the three a little bit too much early on, but they were 4 of 8.
Well, they got a couple of quickies each from Caleb Ledoux and from Jemiah Burr. Coar in the lane, spins it up off the glass for two. Jake Coar with his first basket.
Steal, Amin.
And he'll finish.
That's what he does best, those steals. Lays it in for two. High percentage shot.
Third steal for A&M Corpus Christi as they average nearly 10 per ball game. Uguchukwu back out. Burr will fire the three. Not this time. And Bloom with a good box out and a rebound. Amin will take it coast to coast. Got it blocked, but the finish by Rashawn Thomas. And Rashawn Thomas now with 15 points in the half. And Dave Simmons says, I've seen enough of this. I got to stop the bleeding here with a timeout.
Yeah, look
There's
at the steal.
Look at that.
Just so quick, Amin is. Good court awareness. That's been on display all season from him.
Earlier this season, Amin had 3 straight games of 25 points or more and 4 straight games with 10 field goals. It's pretty tough to do. Let's take a look now at the Southland Conference standings. You can see how compressed this bracket is. The 13 teams, you know, you have 9-3 at the top and 3-8 at the bottom. And everybody is jammed in between. Only 8 get to advance to the postseason tournament in Katy. But you see McNeese at 4-8, just 2 games behind Central Arkansas. So you can see how important this game is. And in the process, A&M Corpus Christi is to 1/2 a game in front of Central Arkansas.
And knocking on that door for fourth. Lamar in fourth right now. Been one of the surprise teams this year. Watched them beat Sam Houston State in overtime the other night. That was a good win for them.
Tick Price has really got his kids in there now. This is his 3rd year, and he's got the team playing his kind of basketball. Very athletic style.
Sure. Tick used to coach here at McNeese.
Step back three by Harvey. No good. Uguchukwu missed the bunny on the follow. Oh, my goodness.
He wanted the foul. Didn't get the call.
Thomas picks up another rebound. He's approaching a double-double here in the first half.
Oh, he was open right there.
Down to 5:20 to go and 15 to shoot for the Islanders. Kilgore back in the ballgame. Amin will fire a long-range three. It's short. Not a good decision by Amin that time, and Uguchukwu clears the rebound. Burr, change of pace dribble, got to the basket for 2-1.
Poor shot on one end, leads to 2 on the other, and a foul.
How many times does that happen? Does he have Amin picks up his 2nd, and Burr with his first 2-point field goal, now with 8.
The defense didn't get back. They were all kind of looking to see who they're supposed to pick up, and Burr just kept on going. That's a mark of a good point guard, too, when you can just keep on driving right to the basket.
And they did not call that foul on Amin, because they've got him on the scoreboard with only 1 foul. I think it was Kilgore that they gave the foul to, number 2, and it's not number 4. Official score is on the other side, and I thought I saw 4 fingers, but it was only 3. Oh, what a nice drive in reverse by Rashawn Thomas. Now it's 17. My goodness.
He's really elevated his game, and really in just the last couple of weeks, we've seen an explosive outburst from him.
And we get a holding call out top as Uguchukwu tried to put the ball on the floor. Jake Coar is going to get the whistle, his first.
Willis Wilson didn't really like that call right there.
No, he did.
Thought it was good defense.
Thought he got a lot of basketball, but the officials say he got the wrist. still pleading his case. 4.5 to go now. McNeese needs to make a run before halftime. Ugochukwu underneath, blocked by Kilgore, but a foul on the elbow, they say. And who gets the whistle? It is Kilgore, and that will be his third. So Kilgore is going to have to sit the final 4:23 of the half. Had four early points. Willis Wilson calls him his most athletic player, with great length and athleticism. Ugochukwu now 3-for-3 from the stripe here in the first half.
Out of Louisville, Texas.
David Bloom will check back in. And that win over Southeastern on Wednesday night. He played almost an Ironman game with his starting five, as all five starters went better than 30 minutes in that ball game. The only reserve to see more than double figures was Cole Martinez, who hasn't checked into this ball game yet. Other guys got in for token views, but he went with his starters for the most part.
That's how you know it's getting close to March.
Yep.
Ugochukwu
with a couple of free throws has four. Here's Thomas.
You need to know who can go the distance in March, you know?
Oh, had his shot blocked by Ugochukwu. Caleb Ledoux with the outlet pass for Burr. And now Harvey. Ugochukwu runs the floor.
Oh,
back at you, says Thomas. And Harvey will hit the three. How about that sequence?
Harvey's
been
shooting
well. And a bad inbounds pass as South couldn't control it. And an unforced error by A&M Corpus Christi. 3:42 to go. And they've come from 16 down to only 11 down. McNeese on a little bit of a roll here, but how about that play from Colin Hale? Islanders on top, 39-28 with 3:42 left in the first. Oh, yes, yes. Uh-huh. All right. You just pee that way. Caesar's got it. Here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana, we've got Southland Conference men's basketball this afternoon. Coming up here in March, from the 6th through the 11th, it's March Madness, the Louisiana High School Finals for the boys right here at Burton Coliseum from the 6th through the 11th, the 11th being Championship Saturday right here at Burton Coliseum.
Top 28. Should be fun.
That bad inbounds pass after the three-point basket by Harvey. The first turnover for Texas A&M Corpus Christi here in the half. 3.5 to go. Five straight points.
Get it
allowed
down.
McNeese to get it to 11. Now do they get it to single digits? Ledoux goes inside for Ugochukwu. Back out to Ledoux. Nice pump fake. Two-point shot. Rolls off. No good. And Amin will take the rebound down for A&M Corpus Christi.
Had the shot he wanted.
Yep.
Got some clearance. Couldn't get it to fall.
Opened up some daylight with that one bounce. South, down low for Thomas. And Ugochukwu again got a piece of that. Poche dishes off to Burr. I'll bet Rashawn Thomas hasn't had two shots in a row blocked this season before now. And we get a foul, and we'll have free throws coming up as Kareem South picks up the whistle. And Steven Uguchukwu will go back to the free throw line for his third trip.
Now they'll get a chance to cut it to single digits. Uguchukwu there.
See what you did?
Yeah, well, it's a good chance for him to show his physicality down low. That's what he needs to do. They need his presence down low in the paint. Someone's got to answer Rashawn Thomas.
Just said announcer's jinx there. You had a chance to get it to single digits. Now he can't because he missed the first free throw. It can stay at 10.
There.
Well, it's all your fault. Five out of six from the line for Uguchukwu for all of his points. A little full court pressure for McNeese. 2-2-1 on the zone trap.
South said, hey, Thomas, you're not a guard. Get down the floor. What are you standing next to me for?
You throw the inbounds and then run. Only eight to shoot now because they took time off getting the ball off the floor. Thomas with five. Trying to go against Uguchukwu. Kicked it out. Launched by Coer. Won't go. Rebound tipped around. And Poche will get it for McNeese. Now with a chance to get into single digits. Uguchukwu through the lane. Going to be a block on Rashawn Thomas. His first. It's nine team fouls. So Uguchukwu will shoot 1-1 here. Watch it again.
Yeah, they're taking it to Thomas now.
Yeah. Yeah, he slid over. He established his position. And when Uguchukwu went to cross over, he went to move with him. And that made it a blocking foul.
There's the single digits.
Six out of seven now for the junior from Louisville. It was 69% for the year. Thomas going to get a breather as Perry Francois with two fouls will check back in with 2:09 left here in the half. One out of two that time for Uguchukwu. 39-30 as we approach the two-minute mark. And again, pressure full court. Amin breaks it. And the Islanders will have 20 to run their offense. South from the left wing, left it short. Rebound tapped around, goes to Harvey. The Cowboys back the other way. Burr leaves for Harvey, back to Burr. Uguchukwu over Francois for two. His first field goal of the game. He's got eight, though.
Uguchukwu out of Argyle's Liberty Christian High School, showing you what he can do. Good ball movement there, driving in for two. Good closing half for him.
Down to a minute 15 left. Here's Francois in the block. He has to kick it back out. Coer harassed outside. Here's South. He'll take a desperation three. It's no good. Rebound batted out and picked up by South. New 30 to shoot for the Islanders as we hit the minute mark. This time a 10-foot runner will go through. Kareem South with eight here in the first half. Lead is nine for the Islanders. They find Harvey open for another three. Can't leave that guy open. His second three, both from the left corner. He's got eight, and it's down to six. And Texas A&M Corpus Christi gonna burn a timeout here with 28.4 seconds to go. But how about this comeback for McNeese? They were down 16 and have come roaring back to within six with 28.4 seconds to go as A&M Corpus Christi has gone a little cold here from the floor. They're gone almost 4.5 minutes without a field goal. They're only 2 points in the last little bit. Coming for the free throw line. 17 points for Rashawn Thomas, who also has 9 rebounds here in the first half to lead all scores. 8 points for Steven Uguchukwu and for James Harvey. As 5 players, all 5 starters, have scored for McNeese, they're the only ones on the score sheet. No bench points for them. 5 bench points for A&M Corpus Christi, courtesy of Colin Hale. So we've got about a 2-second differential. 26 on the shot clock, 28.4 on the game clock. So the Islanders can just about take all the air out of the basketball here in the first half. And maybe stem some of the momentum. Islanders will also get the ball to start the second half unless we have a tied up situation here in the final seconds. Shot clock at 8. Kaur with 5. Down low for Thomas. It'll be an and one. Is it Uguchukwu got the whistle? No. It's going to be on Lamarius Hill. It'll be his second. Let's take a look again. There's Thomas around Hill, drawing the contact. Hill's second. Uguchukwu's got 2. Poche has got 2. So the big players for McNeese each have 2 fouls. Thomas back to the free throw line. Now with 18 points here in the first half. 4 for 4 from the stripe. Five points, 7 to go. So McNeese will have a chance to run it up the floor. 19 and a half for Rashawn Thomas. Here's Burr trying to go against Kaur. Off balance, 3 is off the mark, no good. Good defense by Jake Kaur to close out the final 5.7 seconds at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, which led by as many as 16 in the first half. We'll take an 8-point lead into the locker room here at the intermission. So Thomas, who's averaged 25.7 and 10.2 since missing 2 ball games, 19 in the first half. And with Jeff Power is head coach Dave Simmons.
Here with Dave Simmons, Coach Rashawn Thomas kind of having his way out there. Thoughts about how you can stop him maybe in the second half?
Well, that's a good question. Only thing, I mean, he got off to a great start. I mean, they really shot the ball, not just him. But he's a tough guy to handle one-on-one. But the biggest thing is we kind of slowed him up and got back in the game by going to a zone. So that seemed like that's going to be our fix going back for a defense. That's the only way you can stop him. One-on-one, unless you're double-teaming. But they got some really good shooters out there. You got to keep him off the glass and try to limit his touches. But they got off to a great start. They shot it well. But he was loaded. I know he's got about 20 points at half. I told him if we didn't watch him, he'd get 40 on us. But it's a good game. We got fought our way back into it. Now I think we just got to make some good adjustments at halftime to get back in the game.
Very good. Dave Simmons, head coach of McNeese. Back to you, Tom.
All right, thanks very much. He's got to be proud of the way his team fought back from 16 down. It's an 8-point lead at the break, 43-35. Texas A&M, Corpus Christi on tap. Halftime activities for Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana, coming your way after this timeout.
Changing.
Hello.
It's not a desk job. I'm on my feet all day.
It's Trevor 3 East.
I'm Trevor Bonzer, and I'm a nurse manager at Chris's Spawn Shoreline. The faculty at A&M Corpus Christi, you see the passion in their teaching. They will challenge you, and they will motivate you. They want you to succeed.
97% of A&M Corpus Christi graduates will be working or in graduate school upon graduation. Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your right. Visit us today at tour.tamucc.edu.
Great hunt today, Dad.
Thanks, son.
For more than 15 years, I've helped clients nationwide make solid decisions about investing in gold so they can enjoy what's most important.
Discover the best options for you and your family by calling 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. 866-UCB-GUIDE, 866-822-4843.
Now is the time to learn about gold so you have time to enjoy what's most important.
10 years of intensity. 10 years of dunks, 10 years of three-pointers, 10 years of drives, 10 years of teamwork, 10 years of leadership, 10 years of hustle, 10 years of champions, a decade in Katy. The 2017 Southland Basketball Tournament, March 8th through the 12th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Just as mighty oak trees grow strong in contrary winds, McNeese State University continues to thrive despite the current economic climate. For 5 consecutive years, McNeese has been named one of the best regional universities in the South by U.S. News & World Report. Best Value Schools also ranked McNeese one of the best schools in the state for affordability and return on investment for its graduates. See for yourself why a degree from McNeese just makes sense. Call or visit us online to schedule a campus tour.
welcome you back to Lake Charles, Louisiana, Burton Coliseum, Texas A&M, Corpus Christi with a 43-35 lead over McNeese. We're at courtside here at halftime. Tom Franklin, pleased to be joined by Mike Fulgens, the founder, president, and basketball junkie at Universal Coin and Billing. How you doing, sir?
Thank you, Tom. Great to be back.
Always nice to come over here. Always great for your support of college athletics. How'd you get involved with college sports and being a sponsor?
Well, I played on the McNeese women's basketball team, kind of back in the day. I was the backup center for a year, and Coach Duplashan at LSU said, Mike, shave your beard and legs. I need my backup center. So before there was a Pat Summit, I was the backup center with my best friend's girlfriend was the center, and she went on to play in the WNBA, Vicki Chapman in our Hall of Honor here.
How about that? You know, this Southland Conference season has been crazy. I mean, you look at the standings and how packed these teams are. Nobody's really been able to separate themselves, and what eight teams are going to go to Katy for the state tournament in 3 weeks is really up for grabs.
It really is, and I'm fortunate enough living in Beaumont and coming to Lake Charles. I get to see the teams play in Beaumont and Lake Charles. And really right now, Sam, UNO, and Corpus, to me, seem to be playing the best. Corpus struggled early with some issues of chemistry, but they're doing better now, and they got the best player in the conference. Defensive player of the year last year, Rashawn Thomas, first-team all-conference, and we see it here today. He has 19 points. And he can go inside, outside, put the ball on the floor. He's in triple threat position all the time with the ball in his hands.
However, we saw something here in the first half he probably hadn't had happen to him. He had two consecutive shots blocked. When's the last time he had two shots blocked?
It didn't happen with Mazikor, the big man at Lamar. But Steven Okachuku's pretty long, but he came back and blocked Steven, so he returned
right.
The favor.
Exactly. You know, this has been a crazy college basketball season if you look nationally. There's only one unbeaten team in Gonzaga, and number one is up for grabs. I think we're in for one of the best NCAA postseason tournaments we've seen in a long time.
March Madness is always fun. I covered it for 9 years for the Sporting News. I think it's one of the most fun times of the year. If anybody can go to a Final Four and participate in all the festivities, I encourage them. Second only to coming to Katy to the Southland Tournament. And go to Katy and enjoy the Tex-Cajun food, we call it over there.
So what do you look for from this McNeese team? I mean, they're sitting 4-8. It's been a tough struggle. They won their first two games in the conference and then have had a struggle since then. But they're not out of it here in this closing six-game stretch, of which they got a bunch of home games here.
Well, there are 13 teams in the league. 11 are eligible because Incarnate Word and Abilene are still transitioning. And McNeese, with a few wins at home, can get into the playoffs and anything can happen. But the first two teams get a double bye. Third and fourth get a single bye. You really need to be there because winning four games in four nights is tough in Katy.
That's for sure. That's Mike Fulgens. If you want to know how to take care of your money in your future, Universal Coin and Bullion, what's the address?
We're at 7411 Phelan, and we are the official coin and bullion dealer of the Southland Conference.
There you have it. And if they want to hit you on email or
send it to universalcoin.com or Vicky at universalcoin.com is my assistant.
There you go. Mike Fulgens, the president, founder, and basketball junkie joining us here at halftime. 8-point lead for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. More halftime activities from Burton Coliseum will follow this timeout. Going to do some highlights. Yeah, he's back here. Somebody stole his halftime stats, so Mike Fulgens took it. So I'm, you know, yeah, don't. All right, so you just run it, and we'll shut up when you tell us to shut up. Well, one of us will anyway. No, I understand.
Wrong.
That's my boy. How come he's not interviewing that guy?
Ogochukwu.
8-point lead for Texas A&M. Corpus Christi shooting for their fifth consecutive win. Meanwhile, McNeese trying to snap a two-game losing streak, pulled from 16 down to within 8 here at the intermission. Interesting first half, Jeff, as we look back on it. Started out fairly evenly, and then a burst from Texas A&M Corpus Christi got them out to a 16-point lead before a late finish from the McNeese Cowboys pulled it to within 6 and now 8 here at the intermission. Let's say we take a look at some of the first half highlights for you.
Yeah, Rashawn Thomas, he really got it going for Texas A&M Corpus Christi, but it was the outside shooting from McNeese that got him started.
Right, three ball from Ledoux, an answer for Amin. Kilgore with a floater down the lane.
There's
Thomas. Rashawn Thomas with one of the first of his baskets, a three-point opportunity. Ledoux with his second three ball, both from the same spot. Thomas from the outside in addition to the inside. And then
Burr
with one of his threes. And there's that guy again, number 25, Rashawn Thomas. Amin with the kick and the delivery from the wing for the Islanders. Lance Poche with a tough shot inside. And the lead is 8 for A&M Corpus Christi. 19 points for Rashawn Thomas. A further look at the stats will follow this timeout.
Trevor 3 East.
I'm Trevor Bonzer, and I'm a nurse manager at Christus Bond Shoreline. The faculty at A&M Corpus Christi, you see the passion in their teaching. They will challenge you, and they will motivate you. They want you to succeed.
97% of A&M Corpus Christi graduates will be working or in graduate school upon graduation. Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your island. Visit us today at tour.tamucc.edu.
Great hunt today, Dad.
Thanks, son.
For more than 15 years, I've helped clients nationwide make solid decisions about investing in gold so they can enjoy what's most important.
Discover the best options for you and your family by calling 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. 866-UCB-GUIDE, 866-822-4843.
Now is the time to learn about gold so you have time to enjoy what's most important.
10 years of intensity. 10 years of dunks, 10 years of three-pointers, 10 years of drives, 10 years of teamwork, 10 years of leadership, 10 years of hustle, 10 years of champions, a decade in Katy. The 2017 Southland Basketball Tournament, March 8th through the 12th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Just as mighty oak trees grow strong in contrary winds, McNeese State University continues to thrive despite the current economic climate. For 5 consecutive years, McNeese has been named one of the best regional universities in the South by U.S. News & World Report. Best Value Schools also rank McNeese one of the best schools in the state for affordability and return on investment for its graduates. See for yourself why a degree from McNeese just makes sense. Call or visit us online to schedule a campus tour.
Look at the first half stats showing you Texas A&M Corpus Christi on top by 8. Only 1 turnover to 6 for McNeese. Shooting it at 48%. Rebounds, they lead slightly at 19-6 and 7-0 off the bench. 8-point lead for the Islanders as we get ready for second half action at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles. We'll be back with play right after this. The little things have Texas A&M Corpus Christi on top by 8. They have outscored McNeese 20-4 in the paint, 9-0 off turnovers, 10-5 in second chance points, 4-0 on fast break points, and 7-0 off the bench. Everything heavily favoring Corpus Christi. If you look at the main stat numbers, very, very evenly distributed between the two teams. But those little things have gotten A&M Corpus Christi this 8-point lead.
Hey, worth noting, Stephen Ugochukwu has got 46 fouls in 13 games in the Southland Conference here, 2 tonight. So I'd like to try to keep him clean if possible here in the second half. He had a good run there late in the first half for McNeese.
Paul Martinez has checked in to start the second half, number 2 in the corner. Coher's got the ball out top, back to Martinez with 10 to shoot. Thomas quickly double team. Nice skip pass for South. And now Coher for 3. Off the iron, no good. And Poche will get the rebound.
Part of the problem for Ugochukwu is the fact that he's got to guard Rashawn Thomas also. Thomas with 19 points.
And 9 rebounds in the first half. A rebound shy of a double-double in the first half. Ugochukwu with a pump fake and drive. Had his shot blocked, tried to get it back. Poche's got it. Lost it on the way up and got fouled from behind.
Good hang time right there to draw the foul.
It'll be on Cole Martinez, who just checked in. Martinez, a guy they really need to have on the floor to help open the floor up. He's a great three-point shooter, a great free-throw shooter. He's a solid voice on the floor, but he got hurt in their last non-conference game against Oklahoma State and really hasn't been the same since. His minutes have been severely limited. He missed 4 full games and then has been hit and miss since then. Poche goes 2 for 2 from the line.
Down to 6.
Back to a 6-point game. 1 minute gone by here in the second half. Burr working against South. Here's Martinez.
You heard Dave Simmons telling us about he liked what he saw from his defense there late in the first half. Wants to see more of that.
Right now they're playing man. They changed it up and went zone. As the half progressed, they've come back to man-to-man. Thomas trying to work on Ugochukwu from the free throw line. Nothing but net. 21 now for Rashawn Thomas. Here's Ledoux for 3. Couldn't get it to go this time. And Amin will take the rebound away from Thomas. Amin through the paint, blocking foul against Poche, and that'll be his 3rd.
Take a look at this one more time underneath. Poche kind of with that lean there at the very end.
That's what did it.
Had good position, but just leaned into him.
He was there early enough, but then didn't maintain the verticality. So we have Amin 1 of 2 from the line of the first half. Now with 6 points. Coming off a 15-point effort against Southeastern Louisiana on Wednesday, in which he was 8 for 8 from the free throw line and a rebound shy of a double-double. This time just 1 for 2 from the stripe. He's just 2 out of 4 from the line in this one. Lead is back up to 9 for the Islanders. Try to go down low for Poche, and over the back is Jake Coher with his 2nd foul. Second team foul here for A&M Corpus Christi. New 30 to shoot for the Cowboys.
Talked about Dave Simmons, 11 years at McNeese, but 13th overall. A couple stints here.
Harvey tried to drive, lost the ball. They say it went off a hand of one of the Islanders. Confirmed from the outside. See if we can get a good look at the view here. Yeah, it looked like the last touch was Rashawn Thomas. 27 to shoot.
Only Ralph Ward's been here longer than Dave Simmons. Ward from 1953 to 71, 19 seasons for the Cowboys.
Well, one of the assistant coaches has been here longer.
Dumars, right?
David Dumars, that's right. In and out on the 3 ball from Ledoux is halfway down, and Thomas with another rebound.
You know his brother Joe Dumars from here, of course.
And the 3 from Cole Martinez, and that is exactly what Willis Wilson wants from that young man.
Back out to a 12-point lead, a little 6-0 run here.
You watch when he maneuvers. That right leg is still tender.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
You know, it's a ligament issue, one that doesn't require surgery, but is very difficult to play on and to recover if you're playing basketball with. Pull up by Harvey is good. James Harvey in double figures with 10. Here's Amin underneath the basket. The reverse is blocked by Ugochukwu and taken down by Ugochukwu.
Big play from Ugochukwu as they work the ball around. He's open for three.
Straight away, no good. Martinez the rebound.
Probably not his shot, though.
No, not his shot. Shooting the three ball on the air. He is 40% from behind the arc, so he's not unaccustomed to shooting them. But that one didn't look pretty. Here's Thomas. Got double team back out to Martinez.
Good defense from Steven.
Thomas trying to drive, and Ugochukwu's going to get the foul. That'll be his third.
I think they're working on his psyche a little bit. You know, that he got in foul trouble the other night against New Orleans.
Sure.
Fouled out just 2 minutes into the second half. And
go back at him.
All right. Got him thinking about it. Got three now.
Well, they switch Poche onto Thomas right now. Thomas tries to find the cutter in south. He got slapped on the way by. It's either going to be Poche or Ugochukwu. Oh, they call it on Ledoux. I didn't see where Ledoux was. I saw the big guys in there, and that's Ledoux's second. That's a good thing for McNeese. Three ball on the way is no good by Coer, but in the closeout, Ledoux fouls him.
Cardinal sin number one right there.
So in a matter of seconds, Caleb Ledoux picks up a couple of fouls. You see the closeout here going through the air and crashes into Ledoux. Or to Coer, rather. Coer with a miss on the free throw.
He'll get two more.
Coer is 68% from the free throw line. Out of St. Michael's High School in Austin. Made the second for his third point of the game. Martinez will sit out. And Colin Hale, who had some nice minutes in the first half, for head coach Willis Wilson, gets a return visit here. Played 5 minutes at 5 points off the bench.
Yeah, Martinez checking out. It's good to see him on the floor. You know, he's been hobbled all year, or at least since the Oklahoma State game, as you mentioned.
So Burr picks up the ball and gives it off to Ledoux. Lead has been built out to a dozen. There's as many as 16, reduced to 6, and now back to 12. Cross-court pass. Ledoux on the baseline draws contact from South. It'll be a foul on Kareem South as we hit the 4 minute mark here of the second half. They say Ledoux is in the act of shooting, so he'll shoot here.
You mentioned David Dumar, 16 seasons here with McNeese as an assistant coach. He's seen a lot. Also, David Preston and Eric Wells, 5 and 6 years respectively as assistant coaches.
Caleb Ledoux can go into double figures if he can knock down the second free throw. And he does. He's got 10. 4 minutes gone by here in the second half. A&M Corpus Christi has put the lead back out to 10 points. They break the 2-2-1 zone pressure. Coer finds Thomas. Tried to find Coer on the return pass, but it got deflected. Here's Ledoux. Off for Burrs. Three. It's good. Third three ball of the game for Jemiah Burr. He's got 11. It's a 7-point game.
He was an All-Southland Conference second team player last year. They need his presence now. That's good defense by Burr right there.
Amin finds Coer. He'll drive and finger roll it home.
Well done.
Coer with 6.
Got his man up off the floor and dribbled right around him.
Here's Ledoux for 3. Not this time. Amin, backside rebound. Amin will try to go coast to coast. He did it. Amin has 8. 55-44, 11-point lead for the Islanders. Seems like I'm always trying to chip away, but just can't quite get there.
Yeah, they get it to six, and then it goes right back up to double figures.
Error for Poche at the top of the arc. They look for Ugochukwu back to Poche. Madu off on the wing. Harvey with a tough three. Got a little glass, got some rim, but it wouldn't go down. Amin back the other way. This time they cut him off. Thomas through the lane. Nice move and a jump hook. Won't go. Rebound fought for. Who's got it? Poche with the outlet pass to Ledoux. On the wing, Harvey's three. Not this time. And Amin with yet another rebound. He's had three rebounds in a row on the defensive end for the Islanders.
And he wants him to slow it down a little bit. Oh, watch that lazy pass.
That was dangerous. Harvey almost took it away. Skip pass for Hale. Nice rescue on the sideline. 15 to shoot. Ledoux tried to intercept, could not keep it in play, and finally brings us to an official's timeout. We have 13:49 to go. The Islanders, who led by 8 at the intermission, have tacked 3 more on. It's 55 to 44. 21 points for Rashawn Thomas to lead all scorers.
Sleeps. It's constantly changing.
Hello.
It's not a desk job. I'm on my feet all day.
It's Trevor Three East.
I'm Trevor Bonzer, and I'm a nurse manager at Chris's Spawn Shoreline. The faculty at A&M Corpus Christi, you see the passion in their teaching. They will challenge you, and they will motivate you. They want you to succeed.
97% of A&M Corpus Christi graduates will be working or in graduate school upon graduation. Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your island. Visit us today at tour.tamucc.edu.
Great hunt today, Dad.
Thanks, son.
For more than 15 years, I've helped clients nationwide make solid decisions about investing in gold so they can enjoy what's most important.
Discover the best options for you and your family by calling 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. 866-UCB-GUIDE, 866-822-4843.
Now is the time to learn about gold so you have time to enjoy what's most important.
10 years of intensity, 10 years of dunks, 10 years of three-pointers, 10 years of drives, 10 years of teamwork, 10 years of leadership, 10 years of hustle, 10 years of champions, a decade in Katy. The 2017 Southland Basketball Tournament, March 8th through the 12th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
13:49 left. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with an 11-point lead. 21 points and 11 rebounds for Rashawn Thomas. But right now, McNeese needs some buckets, Jeff. They are just 2 of 9 here in the second half and 1 of 6 from long range. So they've gotten back into the habit of going for that three-point shot again like they did in the first half. They need to get inside and loosen things up for them.
Well, they've been outscored 24-4 in the paint.
Kilgore misses from 3. Rebound taken down by Harvey to Ledoux through the paint with a left-hand shovel for 2.
Will be on Thomas?
No, foul is on Colin Hale. Caleb Ledoux now with a dozen to lead all McNeese scores. They have 3 players in double figures, 12 for Ledoux, 11 for Burr, and 10 for Harvey. Make it 13 now for Ledoux. Back down to an 8-point game. 13 and a half left here in Lake Charles.
The Islander bench has outscored McNeese 10-0.
It's kind of a 1-3-1 zone, but they're trying to keep a man on Thomas at all times. Here's Hale from the right corner. 3 ball goes off the iron and up over the top of the backboard, out of bounds. Now a basket here can make it a 6-point game, and a 3 ball would make it a 5-point game. Ledoux steps in from 20. And right now, Caleb Ledoux is feeling it. He's got 15, 7 of those in the second half. And it's a 6-point game again with 12:50 to play. This Cowboy team won't quit. 15-footer by Thomas, no good. Rebound Poche. Thomas getting a little anxious out there. He got the touch, and it wasn't a great shot, but he wanted to get himself back on the score sheet. Only one basket here in the second half.
A.J. Brown in down low against Thomas. Now he's got the ball.
A little 2-3 zone for the Islanders as well here. Here's Bird, a drive and a travel. And the turnover for McNeese, number 7. But only 2 turnovers for the Islanders. Kilgore will walk it down the floor, get the look from head coach Willis Wilson and put him in motion as Cole Martinez is back in.
How about Joe Dumars earlier? He comes down every now and then and takes care of the folks here at McNeese State.
Well, Martinez's entry pass was tipped and Thomas stepped on the end line as he went out of bounds trying to rescue it. Brings us to another official's timeout, 11:52 to play in the ball game. Once again, McNeese has narrowed what was at one time a 16-point lead down to 6. They get them started early here in Lake Charles to be McNeese fans. Right now, their Cowboys are 6 down, 55-49. And McNeese will have the ball.
Pivotal part of the game here, 11:50 to go. Chance to get it to 4, maybe even 3.
Ledoux way off the mark, and Amin with another rebound will try and lead a 3-on-2 break. He'll go all the way and leave it short with a right hand, but a whistle. Foul, they say, is on Burr. Got him going up on the leg. So Ehab Amin, let's take a look at it here. As Amin runs it out, you saw him go across and clip body against the right knee. So Amin, just 2 out of 4 from the line, is now 3 out of 5. As we mentioned in the first half, he's an 81% free throw shooter. Caleb Ledoux will sit down. He's got 15 points as James Harvey will come back in for McNeese. 1 out of 2 for Amin, who continues that streak from the line. 3 out of 6 now. Been the line 3 times, been 1 out of 2 every time.
Cole Martinez has checked back in for the Islanders now.
Now the ball game is A.J. Brown, number 30, out high with the ball. His first appearance. 3 from Burr, desperation no good, and Amin with yet another rebound. Amin leaves it for Thomas, he'll shoot the 3. Oh, are you kidding me? Wow. 24 for Rashawn Thomas. Here's Brown, has to kick it back out. Amin now with 8 rebounds in the ball game. Here's Poche for three. It's no good. Rebound into the arms of Amin again. Ahead for Thomas. He wasn't looking. He runs it down in the corner. Got it back out to South, and now the Islanders will settle it down.
When Amin's running the floor, everybody's got to pay attention. He'll give you a no-look pass.
Absolutely. 10 to shoot. Thomas down low for Amin. Goes one way, then the other. Back outside for South's three. In and out, no good. Rebound tipped. Amin can't get it. Taken away by LeCoux. Here's Bird of the basket. He'll kick it out to Harvey instead.
I think Bird should have taken that shot. He was so close.
I think so. He thought maybe they could buy three on this instead of his two. Down by 10. Points are at a premium. Harvey, deep three. No good. Highest of all, Thomas with the outlet pass for South. South in the lane, between two, had it slapped away by LeCoux.
There was some contact.
Big Euro step in, finished by Jemiah Burr, who's got 13.
Burr driving the lane right there, kind of making up for that choice last time to get rid of it.
He did take it all the way that time, and it worked out for him. 9:15 to go. The lead is 8 for the Islanders, just like it was at the intermission. Kilgore looking for Harvey. They find him at the free throw line. Wow. Went right around, round to the basket.
What a great move.
Like Brown's feet were in cement.
Got my vote for Southland Conference Player of the Year.
He's got 26 in this one. And stepping on the sideline before he started his drive was Harvey. Turnover. Unforced error as Brown's going to have a seat as Ukuchukwu comes back in.
Yeah, right.
Yep, the heel.
Right there. Wow, his foot slipped a little bit, looked like.
So another turnover for McNeese.
How about that camera work right there, Tom?
We got cameras all over the place here. You know, they tell me there's only 5, but I think they're lying. You know, I think we got about 15. We keep finding the right view at the right time. And a travel by Amin, that shuffle step. Haven't seen that called. That's the first time in today's ballgame we've seen it, but that's been a constant throughout college basketball. Officials have been honing in on that move where the players take a little shuffle before putting the ball on the floor. They got Amin that time.
Yeah, Amin walked up to one of the officials and just kind of asked him, what did you see? And he said, well, you gave me that 1-2 shuffle that we've talked to you about.
Yeah.
David Cusick, Raymond Shipps, and Henry Howard are officials today, by the way. Good Southland Conference group.
Jacob Ledoux with the drive, couldn't get it. Tipped around twice, no good. And finally, Joe Kilgore clears. Out to Amin. Amin through the lane for Coher, and he'll slow it down.
Coher didn't like the numbers and figured, hey, the clock's our ally. Let's take some time off.
Have a 10-point lead as we go under 8 minutes to go. Shot clock is at 8. Coher tried to penetrate, left it down low. Reverse is no good by Schmidt, who is in. Loose ball taken by Harvey, and he spins and gets it to Poche and return pass. Good hustle by McNeese. Driving the baseline is LeCoux, and we get a foul on the drive. And it's going to be on Elijah Schmidt, who just checked in. It'll be his first. See a nice drive there by Coher. And a finish by Amin. A 10-point lead for the Islanders. 7:32 left here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles. Among the history here at Lake Charles, the retired number four jersey at McNeese from Joe Dumars. Outstanding collegiate player here before going on to a long time and very successful NBA career with the Detroit Pistons.
Recognized as a Louisiana legend, and he definitely is.
Rightly so. McNeese needs to find the hoop. They're just 5-18 here in the second half for 28%, 1-9 from long range. They can't get the ball to go through. They're going to have a hard time erasing this 10-point lead in the final 7:20.
There's a foul.
There's a foul on Thomas reaching around Ugochukwu. And for Thomas, it'll be his second.
Kind of got his hand in there. You heard the slap.
16 fouls against the Islanders, 5 against the Cowboys here. So Caleb Ledoux will inbound. Throws it out high for James Harvey. Now Jacob Ledoux. Caleb Ledoux from 20, no good, but the follow by Jacob is good. His first point.
Brother there to help out his brother, huh?
Under 7 to go in the lead, down to 8. As Kyle Brown is now in to run the point for the Islanders, number 0. Here's Kilgore from the free throw line. No good. Rebound taken down by Kareem South. Brown thought about it, and South lost it. Turnover number 5 for A&M Corpus Christi. 4 of them here in the second half. Nice high screen set by Ugochukwu. And running into it is Kyle Brown to pick up his first, but that's now 7 team fouls against the Islanders. It'll mean free throws coming up for James Harvey with 6:24 to go. As Harvey will make his first trip to the line. He's a 78% free throw shooter. First one is good. He's got 11.
Amin checks back in the game now for Smith.
You know that put back by Jacob Ledoux just a moment ago was the first bench points for McNeese in this ball game.
10-2.
And Harvey goes 2-for-2 from the stripe. He now has a dozen. The lead is back down to 6 with 6:20 left.
Yeah, if they can hit their free throws down the stretch, McNeese can stay in this game. They're going to get some opportunities.
Well, they're in the bonus now. So every time they're fouled, either in the act of shooting or not, they'll be shooting free throws. Thomas on the baseline over Ugochukwu. Left it short. Ugochukwu clear the rebound. Quick to Caleb Ledoux.
Watch that foul.
Harvey in the corner for 3. Yes. Harvey, who had 60 three-pointers last year to lead McNeese, has 3 in today's ball game as part of his 15 points. And it's a 3-point game now with 5 minutes and 35 seconds to play.
James Harvey and Caleb Ledoux have been leading the way for the Cowboys.
Here's Amin in the paint with the left hand high off the glass. What a good shot by it. Ehab Amin, who's got 11. He's just the second Islander in double figures, buying the 26 from Thomas. Driving the basket and the finish. Jacob Ledoux with his second bucket. Brown slid to the ground, lost the ball, rolled out of bounds. Turnover. A&M Corpus Christi will go back to McNeese with a chance to pull even closer in a 3-point game. Watch Brown just lost his footing, and then as he tried to pick up the ball, couldn't get it. That'll earn Kyle Brown a seat on the bench with head coach Willis Wilson. Dave Simmons exhorting his bunch as Ugochukwu will check out. Now Richard LeCou will be the biggest man on the floor for them. Are they attending to a little bit of an injury here for Ugochukwu? That's what the trainer's looking at him. That's why we have the slight pause in action.
Maybe bloody lip
cut
there.
Cut out of the chin or the lip, yeah.
I think the lip.
Inbounds for Jacob Ledoux. Hey,
Try to go pick and roll with LeCoux, couldn't get it done. Ledoux and LeCoux, you gotta be careful saying those names together. Caleb Ledoux, rainbow three, halfway down. Ugochukwu with a putback.
Now he's at his average for the season at 10 points. They needed that basket.
And it's a one-point game with 4:35 to play. Thomas from 15, too strong. Ugochukwu clears. McNeese with a chance to get their first lead since the first basket of the game and a travel. Caleb Ledoux got stuck in the lane and traveled. May have turned his ankle in the process. Oh, they had an opportunity there on the turnover. Watch him here.
Yeah, Jacob Ledoux here. Just one extra step and about there, he kind of lost his footing or something.
Little stumble.
Tough break. They had all the momentum going their way, trying to take the lead there.
Hakeem South misses for three. And Caleb Ledoux clears the rebound. And again, McNeese with a chance to go in front.
That's a good thing Caleb and Jacob are wearing different numbers. They look exactly the same.
They're identical. There's no question about that.
They're identical.
Hairdo and all. Free ball by Harvey is no good. And Joe Kilgore clears the rebound for A&M Corpus Christi, who can keep the lead here with a bucket as we're under 3:40 to go. Kilgore scoreless in the second half, had four in the first half.
It started with defense. This run from McNeese has been because of their defense.
Thomas underneath, got it to go, and one. They're going to get the foul on Ugochukwu, and it's going to be an and-one opportunity for Rashawn Thomas. Big hoop there for A&M Corpus Christi. Brings us to an official's timeout with 3:23 left. We got a dandy here at the Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles. McNeese trying to erase a 16-point deficit. They trail by three.
Great hunt today, Dad.
Thanks, son.
For more than 15 years, I've helped clients nationwide make solid decisions about investing in gold so they can enjoy what's most important.
Discover the best options for you and your family by calling 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. 866-UCB-GUIDE, 866-822-4843.
Now is the time to learn about gold so you have time to enjoy what's most important.
10 years of intensity, 10 years of dunks, 10 years of three-pointers, 10 years of drives, 10 years of teamwork, 10 years of leadership, 10 years of hustle, 10 years of champions, a decade in Katy. The 2017 Southland Basketball Tournament, March 8th through the 12th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Just as mighty oak trees grow strong in contrary winds, McNeese State University continues to thrive despite the current economic climate. For five consecutive years, McNeese has been named one of the best regional universities in the South by U.S. News & World Report. Best Value Schools also rank McNeese one of the best schools in the state for affordability and return on investment for its graduates. See for yourself why a degree from McNeese just makes sense. Call or visit us online to schedule a campus tour.
Southland Conference Basketball on Route Sports Southwest is sponsored by Universal Coin and Bullion, the official coin and bullion dealer of the Southland Conference. We got a great one going on here. 65-62, Texas A&M Corpus Christi has led almost from the outset. First basket of the ball game went to McNeese State, a three-pointer. And after a couple of baskets from A&M Corpus Christi got the lead, that's it. They've been in front ever since. And Rashawn Thomas has been a big part of that. 28 points and 12 rebounds in the game. At the free throw line. Try and complete a three-point play. Does not. First miss from the line. He was 5 for 5. So the lead stays at 3. 3:15 left.
Good defense by the Islanders, switching around.
Here's Burr, kicks it off to Harvey. Covered up by Corey, he'll go baseline, the floater no good. Uguchukwu, the putback, too strong. Wait a minute. We called offensive gold or defensive goaltending. Somebody either grabbed the rim or the net. One or the other. We'll see if we get a look at it here. But I saw the basket. Watch here. Here comes. Yeah, right there. Yeah,
Rashawn Thomas got it.
It was Rashawn Thomas who got that. So it's an offensive goaltending. Give the points to Uguchukwu. He's got a dozen, and we get a one-point game with 2:40 left.
Good game for Steven today, especially after leaving last game early against New Orleans.
Right, he's got a dozen points. If they credit him with the foul rebound there, he's got 10 rebounds as well. Thomas from the free throw line, no good. Poche rips the rebound down, and the Cowboys can go in front with a bucket. Deflected by Core, goes out of bounds. And Ledoux pulled those hands away right at the very last minute, otherwise it was going to be off of him.
I like the way Coer plays out there. He hustles, always playing good defense.
To shoot for the Cowboys. They have it led. Since the opening minutes of the game. Oh, the steal as Burr lost it. And Coer got the loose ball and gave it to Kareem South. As we go under 2 minutes to play.
Burr only averages about two turnovers a game, but inopportune time there with just about a minute 49 to go.
They have really taken Thomas out of the game here in the second half. Backdoor pass for Amin for the finish. Ehab Amin with 13, the lead grows to three.
Nice assist, Kilgore.
Ledoux to try and tie it, no, and Amin back the other way for the rebound with 1:25 to go. Ehab Amin with a double-double now. 13 points and 10 rebounds with that one.
Now they're gonna work that clock a little bit.
15 to shoot. Kilgore will put it in motion here with eight. Calling for somebody to come back out. Instead, he's going to have to attack. Gave it to Coer. The scoop with the right hand. How about Jake Coer with that shot?
Got that to go. Surprised he wasn't fouled. Somehow avoided the foul.
5-point lead again for A&M Corpus Christi. 50 seconds to play. Three for Harvey. Won't go. Rebound. Thomas takes it away from Poche.
It's a big rebound by Thomas.
Now McNeese has got a foul. Coer gives it to Amin. They're killing time. Thomas quickly got rid of it. And now Kareem South is finally fouled with 29.6.
Yeah, a little too much time came off the clock.
Oh, yeah. Uguchukwu with a foul. They wasted at least 15 seconds there. Four fouls on Uguchukwu, and Kareem South will make his first trip to the free throw line, 77% on the year. Really blossoming here in the second half of the season for Willis Wilson.
What did we say earlier this week? You got to find ways to win these games late. A lot of the Southland Conference games this year have been close. The teams are on top of the teams who've been finding a way to win.
South with the first one, he'll get the bonus, 29.6. He can make it a three-possession game here with the second free throw. And does. Very cool under pressure for the redshirt freshman from Toronto, Canada. Almost a steal by Kilgore. And a steal by Amin.
Who else?
Goes behind the back, gets the ball in front court. And Harvey finally has to foul him with 17 seconds to go. You know, one thing that McNeese has avoided is the steals. That's only four steals in the ball game for A&M Corpus Christi, and they average nearly 10 per contest. But Amin with a big one right there.
Second in the nation in steals, as you mentioned. Picking up another one here.
And rattles the free throw in and out. No good. He's had a tough time for the line. Down to 13 seconds. Ledoux, no good. Tip is good by Poche with 9.6 to go. And Dave Simmons will call a timeout. We'll take it with him with 9.6 to go. We have a 5-point game, 71-66, A&M Corpus Christi, that far away from their fifth consecutive win here in Lake Charles. Yes.
Thomas.
Make sure you get him. He's where is he? There he is. He's 30 minutes. He's 26 points. We got him for 20. We got him for 28 and 12. 28 and 12. Yes. Okay. Yeah. So we need a break between the interview and. Okay. No, I was talking once the buzzer goes off. We'll keep it there here for the interview. Okay. All right, so we're .6 seconds to go. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a 71-66 lead over a scrappy McNeese Cowboy team today. A&M Corpus Christi to put it in play here. Underneath their defensive basket, Cole Martinez to throw it in. Finds Ehab Amin. They foul him immediately. The foul is on Lance Poche. And the way that Amin has struggled from the line, that's a good guy to follow. In normal circumstances, he'd be the last guy you'd want to follow on this Islander team at 81% from the stripe. But in today's ball game, Amin has struggled, as he is just 3 of 7. 13 points, 10 rebounds for his double-double. So Amin with a double-double, Thomas with a double-double at 28-12. With 8.5 to go, Ehab Amin, the junior from Alexandria, Egypt. Played a lot of international ball for the Egyptian national teams and the under-18s. And now this will pretty much seal the deal here with 8.5 to go if he makes the second one. And he does. 3-possession game, 7-point lead for the Islanders. They have to pick it up in backcourt. Jacob Ledoux. For Poche for 3, out top, no good. Rebound tip, no good. Rebound Thomas will secure his 13th rebound and secure the 14th win of the season for Texas A&M Corpus Christi and 5 in a row here in Southland Conference play as they come away with a hard-fought 73-66 victory over a very scrappy bunch from McNeese. 28 points for Rashawn Thomas. And Jeff Power has got our player of the game for a post-game interview. Jeff, take it away.
Rashawn Thomas joining us now. 28 points. I got 13 rebounds on that last one right there. You just told me you were trying to get 28 and 20, but, hey, you'll take the win too, right?
Of course we're trying to take the win, but, that was something I was shooting for. It's a game that I won. But most importantly, we got this win today, and that's what we need going into the conference tournament.
You've won 5 in a row. Thoughts about the way this team's been playing since you were suspended and a chance to kind of show an opportunity what this team's all about down the stretch?
Most definitely. You know, we kind of fell off early, and we're catching our stride now. So we're just trying to put together a couple wins, get a good run going into the conference tournament, and do what we need to do, you know, ultimately come out with a conference championship.
Hey, one more road game coming up for you guys. Thoughts about just staying clean on the road?
You know, we got to stay focused. You know, early we were pretty bad on the road starting off the season. So we know that we need to lock in and stay together, most importantly, on the road because, you know, we're away from home, we're away from fans. So we got to stick together and motivate each other.
There you go. Rashawn Thomas, 28 points. It's back to you, Tom.
Thank
you.
All right, Jeff, thanks very much. 28 points and 13 rebounds. And a new look at the conference standings here as A&M Corpus Christi improves. Now, they are now 7-5. We haven't given A&M Corpus Christi the win here. They're 7-5 down on the season. Came in at 6-5. 5 consecutive wins now for the Islanders. McNeese falls back to 4-9. And the struggle to get into playoff position got just a little bit harder for Dave Simmons' tough team. But boy, oh boy, did they scrap down the wire. Down 16 in the first half, cut it down low and got it to 1 and had a couple of opportunities to take the lead, but never could. And as we see quite often in basketball, when a team gets behind by double figures, they invest so much energy to try and erase that deficit that once they get close, they can't finish the deal. And that was the case here today as McNeese got it to one but could never get in front. So Texas A&M Corpus Christi wins it by a score of 73-66. To move to 14-9 on the season and 7-5 in the conference. McNeese now 7-17 and 4-9 in Southland Conference play. So for Jeff Power and our entire crew, this is Tom Franklin saying so long from Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Grow strong in contrary winds. McNeese State University continues to thrive despite the current economic climate. For five consecutive years, McNeese has been named one of the best regional universities in the South by U.S. News and World Report. Best Value Schools also ranked McNeese one of the best schools in the state for affordability and return on investment for its graduates. See for yourself why a degree from McNeese just makes sense. Call or visit us online to schedule a campus tour.